His old native Indian tale by a Cherokee chief teaching his grandson about life.
"A fight is going on inside of me," he said to the boy. "It was a terrible fight, and it is between two wolves. One is evil. He has anger, envy, sorrow, regret, greed, arrogance, guilt, false pride, superiority, self-doubt, and ego. The other is good. It is joy, peace, love, hope, humility, kindness, empathy, generosity, truth, compassion, and faith. This same fight is going on inside of you, and inside every other person too." The grandson thought about it for a minute, and then asked his grandfather, "Which wolf will win?" The old chief simply replied,
"By the one you feed."
Remember, it all happened about 25 years ago, back in the spring of 1989. When they found that girl out there in Mr. Borland's old cornfield, I tell you, we'll never forget about where they found her and things they talked about and how they found her boyfriend tied up in the car and stuff, and notes the killer left behind, and stuff like that. Remember, it had the whole town on edge. We was all nervous and afraid to even go outside at night. Wasn't hardly our kids out of our sight, afraid of what would happen and whatnot. I just remember it was a hard time back then. We was all scared to death about what had happened. Wasn't long after that, about a week or so, the accident happened down at the paper mill with Walter and Ethan. I tell you, I try to forget what happened that day, but I still hear that boy's screams and still see what happened in my dreams at night. Still bothers me to this day. But I remember the next day after that accident happened, the detectives went over to Ethan's neighborhood, tried to talk to him at his house and stuff, but he was long gone. He had already left. Remember, the police said they went inside and searched the house, and things they found inside, I tell you, it's hard to believe. I couldn't imagine that boy being like that. They said the wallpaper was hanging off the walls, and there was claw marks and stuff, and writings on the walls and stuff like that, and pictures of missing people, and pictures of people taken from the wood lines and stuff, where he's hiding out in the woods and stuff, and spying on people and stuff like that. Then I remember they said they went to the kitchen, opened the refrigerator, and there was bleached animal skulls and stuff like that. I guess where he'd been doing some kind of rituals and sacrifices or something. I tell you, it's just hard to believe, you know, thinking that boy could have done something like that. Remember, he tried to find his box truck, but his box truck was missing. They claimed he must have been driving in that thing, but they never did find him. Everything kind of went quiet after that, you know. It is until now. All this stuff going on, these murders, stuff happening across the country, man. It's, and all these notes he's leaving behind us. It's really got everybody worried that this might really be the GTK. He might be back. If he's back, Lord help us. We need some help with all this. It ain't gonna be good if he is back.